paucity of allocation time, we won't be able to do justice to both the topics. So we shall see today the significance of Ram Navami. If there is one God that is simply the sin ka nan of Hinduism, it is Ram and Bhagavan Sri Krishna. Bhagavan Sri Ram in Hindu's life has enormous significance. The birth of Bhagavan Sri Ram is not an ordinary event. When the Almighty Principle decides to descend itself, avatarita, then the avatars are formed. Avatars are of different types. When Bhagavan decides to have an influence on the entire mankind, which is expected to last for a longer period, longer the period, higher the avatar. Swami Vivekananda himself said that Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, Thakur and myself, we have come and our influence will be there. Swami Vivekananda will be remembered for 1500 years. That was the prophetic statement by Swamiji himself. In comparison to that, in comparison to the avatar of Varishtha Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, Bhagavan Sri Ram avatar is Yuga avatar. Entire Kali Yuga, as long as the Yuga lasts, shall reverberate with the sound of Ramanama. Ramanami is celebrated on Chaitra Shuddha Navami all over India. There is not a single corner of India where Ramanami is not celebrated. An enormous saintly people, rishis, have been born devoted to Bhagavan Rama and who actually had darshana of Sakshat Darshanam of Sri Rama. Samartha Ramadas of Maharashtra, Bhadrachalam Ramadas of Telangana, and similarly, all the saints in south as well as in north of the caliber of Tulsidas, whose Tulsi Ramayana Ramacharitamanasa is Ajaramar Kruti. Valmiki Ramayan reverberates in the mind of a Hindu child since the childhood, I would say since the womb, because every pregnant woman is encouraged to listen to the Itihasas, which is one of that is Ramayanam, so that the qualities of Rama will be inculcated in the fetus that is about to be born. What is an ideal for a Hindu? An ideal for a Hindu is to become Rama. A Adarshaputra, Adarsha Bhrata, Adarsha Raja, Adarsha Pati, Adarsha Purusha, Adarsha Grahastha, Vashishtha's Adarsha Vidyarthi, and Adarsha Yodha. In spite of having a war with the mightiest of the mighty Ravana, never ever any bad word emanated from the mouth of Bhagavan Ramachandra. Such was the legendary Rama, whose Saguna avatar prompts us to do the Saguna Puja. But there are two types of Rama, and we must focus ourselves, being the students of Advaita, on the other aspect of Rama. Dasharathi Rama is the Saguna Puja Uddishta, but the Niranjana Rama is the Nirvikara Rama, Nirguna Rama is the one that we are supposed to focus ourselves on. And that is why the entire Ramayana has to be understood in the context of this particular aspect of Bhagavan Sri Rama. Bhagavan Sri Rama is Kutastha. the Brahman itself, which has manifested in this world. In the upper Brahma, he has manifested as Bhagavan Shri Rama, but Bhagavan Shri Rama is Brahman itself, and it is dwelling in every one of us in the form of Kutastha. When that Kutastha gives its light of the Chaitanya to the Antakkarana, the Chidabhasa illuminating the Antakkarana, meaning the Buddhi and Chidabhasa together, is the Janaki Mata. The Sita Mata is nothing else but the Shakti, Shakti Swarupini of the same Bhagavan Ramachandra. That is why she is also considered as Prakruti or Maya. So the Mayotpatti is very difficult to describe. Bhagavan Shankaracharya has described Maya as Sat Asat Vilakshan, and nothing particular cannot be said about the nature of Maya. She is truth, she is untruth, and she is both. And that is the reason why Avidya Karana Janatva, being the reason for the Janaki, for the Chidabhasa. So Janaki is Manasakanya, she is not born to anybody. Janaka Raja had done Pratipalan of Sita Mata, but she was not born, because the Maya cannot be born to the Brahman. But yes, it has to stay under the shadow and the tutelage of Brahman. So she becomes a Manasakanya. When Shuddha Buddhi has a Chidabhasa of Rama into it, then the Kutastha and Chidabhasa becomes one. The Ram and Sita gets married. And the Parinaya of Rama and Sita, coming together of the Chidabhasa and the Kutastha in the Antakkarana, leads to a kingdom called Ayodhya. The place where there are no wars, no qualms, no differences, no dvait, nothing exists there except infinite bliss. It is the same Rama who was under the tutelage as a student with Vasishtha. If you look at the Yoga Vasishtha, it is very clear that Vasishtha Muni is nothing else but Shuddha Atma Tattva. Vasi and Stha, these are the two words which make Vasishtha. That where the permanent dwells means the Atma Tattvam. So it is the Atma Tattvam who is the guru of Bhagavan Ramachandram. And when he has come into the Saguna Rupa, the entire creation is his friend. That is the reason why Guru Vishwamitra, Vishwamitra means friend of a creation, Vishwamitra. It is a friend of the creation, means the Hiranyagarbha Avastha of the Prakrutyudbhava Vishwa. So Ishwara Rupa has to have a Rut and Sat into it. When the creation was brought into existence as Vishwamitra, then the creation has to undergo the Rut and Sat as per the cosmic order, and any obstacle to that is called Asura. This Asuri Pravrutti, which is existing and dwelling in our mind, is only annihilated when Vishwamitra calls for the Atma Tattvam, Bhagavan Ramachandran, to the fore, so that the Asuras are annihilated and the Yajna, Tapa and Jnana Karma can go unabated. Bhagavan Ramachandra is born to Dasharatha. Dasharatha is the one who is having reigning on the horses of 10 horses chariot. Atma tu sarathi shariram rathamevacha indriyani tu hayanam manaha pragravamevacha. Kathopanishad tells us, ji dashashva, the karmendriyas and the jnanendriyas, has to be controlled by the shamadama, and he is the one who is married to three queens, Kaushalya, Sumitra and Kaikai. Kaushalya represents the buddhi, Sumitra represents the manam, and Kaikai represents the ahankara. The buddhi being adhya vasaitmaka, nishchaya, to the buddhi is born Rama. So if you want to have a Rama to be born on Ramanavami, the adhya vasaitmaka buddhi has to be very strong with determination, nishchayatmaka. Tukaram Maharaj says, Tukamane hechi phala nishchayache bada. The nishchaya has to be there. So when the buddhi decides to make some nishchaya, the Ram is born in that buddhi. In the antakkarana is Sumitra. Mana is called Sumitra. She gives birth to Lakshmana and Shatrughna. While Kaikai, although from the Vikrutika Ahankara, the Kaikai is born, but the son that is born is from the Prakrutika Ahankara, so he always chases for the knowledge because he intends to be basking in the light of knowledge. The one who basks in the light of knowledge is called Bharata. And that is the reason whenever the Rama is about to leave you, if it has left from your heart and gone into the world, that means the Vanavasa, the Atma Tattvam has to be worshipped. But such an Atman, the Prabhu Ramachandran, if it is not residing in the heart, it is simply because of the dull wit, the lack of intelligence, the lack of Viveka. And the lack of Viveka or the dull wit is called Manthara. Mantha and Ara are the two words. Mantha means dull, Ara means witted, dull witted. The one whose buddhi is not Vikasita and the one who does not use the Viveka, the Manthara enters into the mind and then requests the Ahankara, the Kaikai, to dislodge the Atma Tattvam from the Simhasana. And that is the reason for the Atma Tattvam to come back. We have to behave like Bharata so that the Rama is again born in our heart, for which we require to do Atma Tattva Anusandhana. For the Anusandhana, the Lingam of Rama, the Padukas, is nothing else but the Nama Japa. The Bhajana Sankirtana and Navavidha Bhakti is recitation of that Rama which has gone into the jungle, Aranyam, to be brought back and to be installed into the Simhasanam of our own heart. When the Rama comes back and gets installed back into the Ayodhya, then the mind, the Antakkarana, becomes a serene shantim abhigacchati. Lakshmana represents Lakshma Chinne Pradhanecha Apara Brahma. He is the Linga Chinna Purushottama. Unless Lakshmana is a perceptible form of Bhagavan Ramachandra, because they are always together. The lingam, the chinna cannot be separate from the identity. Shatrughna is sangasteshu hanyate, destroyer of the foes. Shatrughna represents the vairagyam. So if you have Shatrughna with you, the one who develops vairagya, if Janaki Mata is with you, having Shuddha Chitta Buddhi, and if the Apara Brahma Puja is there in the form of Lakshmana, then the Rama can be born in the heart. Aranyam means arthate gamyate sheshe vayasi, a land neither grazed nor cultivated, neither grazed achara nor cultivated achara. So that means where the chara and achara are not there, that is called aranyam. And that is the place where the different vishayas only exist. The marichi is representative of the lobha pratika. The golden deer indicates the ajatavada, the deer that never existed, but the buddhi, the chidabhasa, felt that it is existing because it got separated from putastha. The Rama went for killing the deer. When the atma tattvam goes away from us, that is the time the chidabhas get deluded and get kidnapped by nothing else but Ravana. The Ravana is the dhatu of Ravana is Ru. Ru means Rodana, screaming, roaring. Who are the things which are screaming or roaring? The Vishayas. The desires born from the ego, constantly looking for material wealth. That is the reason why such a person then robs the Chidabhasa and keeps it away from the Kutastha. The Janaki is gone away and the Bhagwan Rama has to now wage a war to bring it back. In between, this particular disillusionment of Ravana leads to two main reasons. One is the constant enmity with the Vishayas and the world around. We are not Sampurna Maitri Bhava. Because of Durabhiman and Dambha, the Shurpanakha will constantly flare up in our mind, and the need to have Chidavasa engaged into subject and Vishaya, so Asha, Icha, Trushna, Apiksha, Spruha and Yachana, instead of realizing that whatever God has given is enough for me, Yallabhase Nija Karmo Pate Vittam Tenam Vinodaya Chittam, if we do not do this, then the Ravana in us comes to the fore. Now the only way we can really take this fight forward is to go through Kishkindhakand. And for that, you need to kill the Vali. Vali means in Sanskrit, wrinkle or fold, which indicates Audasinya and Tamas. Unless we destroy the Vali and reinstate Sugriva, the one who has Griva, well-trained reins, and we do need the help of Hanuman, the Ponaputra. The Pancha Mahabhuta is dedicated to Bhagavan Ramachandra. From Ram comes all the power. From Ram comes all the karma and the karma phalas. So Chidabhasa Mukti requires Hanuman Shakti. Hanuman Shakti means Brahmacharya, Dhyana and Viryam. So Bhautika Vishaya Jangala, the Sita is lost in that Ananyam. And what is happening in these Vishayas? The Rakshasini, they are eating all the flesh and the fruits on the trees are drying because they don't eat the fruits. They are eating something which is not to be eaten. That is called Tamoguna Pradhanyata. We are doing the same thing. And that is the reason why we attend the satsangas like this Sandhya in order to have the Mudrankita from the Chinmaya. It is nothing else but the Rama Tattva who keeps appearing in the form of Gurudeva. And when we have the first encounter with Gurudeva, it is precisely like Sita Mata getting the Mudrika from the Hanuman. Simply waiting for Hanuman will not work. An incessant japa of Sita Mata for the beloved Rama forced the destiny to bring the Hanuman Pavanaputra with the Mudra. That is why a consistent approach is required so that the Ram is born in our heart and he rules forever in our Ayodhya. Our life has to be Ayodhya. It can't be full of stress and wars. That is why the Rama Setu has to be brought to release the Sita. For that, you require Ashirvad from the Kutastha Bhagavan Sri Ramachandra. You require Vichara Vanara Sahacharya. You require multiple thoughts to help you, but all good thoughts, that is called Vanara Sahacharya. But the one single strong thought of only remembering God is called Pramukha Vichara Vanara, is Hanumanta. And then how do you start this work of releasing the Chidabhasa Rupi Sita from Sri Lanka of the Ravana? For that, we have to start doing the Karya. Each Karya is a stone for this Setu. Each Karya has to be written with the word Ram, and then the Karya will be Safala. That is how Dvaita to Advaita Setu is to be built. Then the war will be undertaken. Bhagavan Sri Ram will be coming in our heart to beat all those Ravanas in our mind. And the last bastion is nothing else but the Ahankara. Once the Ahankar is killed, the Chidabhas, the Sita Mata will be released, and again Rama, Bhagavan Ramachandra and Sita Mata will come back to Ayodhya. That is the philosophical significance of Ramanavami, which has to be kept in mind by us always, being the student of Advaita. So beautifully it has been captured by none else than Bhagavan Santa Kabir. Kabir Maharaj says, hey, devotee, don't always talk about Dasharathi Rama. He is Saguna Rupa. But talk more about the Niranjana Rama. Niranjana Rama. Ram Niranjan Nyarare. Ram Niranjan Nyarare. Anjan Sakalapasarare. Everything in this world is Anjana. Even the Vedas, even the Shankara, even Brahma, even Govinda. Why? The only one antim tattva is Niranjana Rama. Anjana utpatti, Anjana omkar, Anjana mange sabavistar. Anjan means prakruti, maya. Anjana brahma, Anjana shankara, Anjana gopisanga govindure, Ram Niranjana narare. Anjana bani, Anjana ved, Anjana kiya nana bhed. Anjana vidya, Anjana pathapurana, Anjana ghokat ghokat gyan re. Anjana bhati, Anjana dev, Anjana ki kare, Anjana sev. We are in prakruti and we are doing the prakrutic study. Anjana bhati, Anjana dev, Anjana ki kare, Anjana sev. Anjana nache, Anjana gave, Anjana bheshi, Ananta idare re. But that is all Anjan. Anjana kaha kaha lagaketa. Dana punita paptirath deta. Kahe kabir koi birala jane. Only one amongst them. Anjana chadi ananta hi dagare. Ram niranjana nyarare. Anjana sakala pasarare. Anjana sakala pararare. With the blessings of Gurudeva, who was nothing else but Bhagavan Ramachandra, the same principle residing into all Jivan Muktas. He came for the help of all of us. We must have done Punya Karma in our past birth. That is why we have, at least our Buddhi is telling us to recite the name of Vishnu Sahasranama and of Chinmaya Saraswati. So let us pray on the day of Ram Navami to nothing else but the Hanuman Bhakta and Ram Bhakta Chinmaya Saraswati Maharaj to help and bless all of us with the presence of Rama in our thoughts, the presence of Rama in our speech, and the presence of Rama in this Deha itself. And then when Sita Mata and Rama are there residing in my heart, in every heart, if I'm able to see that, then the life will be nothing else but an Ayodhya ruled by Rama. Jai Shri Ram.